Cologne versus Munich. Tomorrow's members of government play to win the favor of the electorate. The eco-policy simulation game is like real life. One wrong decision and the complex system is thrown out of joint. If you wish to avoid a revolt, there's one thing you need first and foremost, and that's networked thinking.
In the eco-policy game, the player assumes the role of head of government of the fictional country Cybernetics Land and has to decide in which areas of life investments should be made. As a result, he learns how interrelated factors in these areas produce changes where he never would have expected them.
Hans Werner Hansen created a nationwide contest from the game invented by Frederik Wester, a type of Olympic Games for networked thinking.
The
Eco-Policy Aid is a contest that takes place in secondary schools and among them. We motivate instructors and students to use networked thinking and then to make a comparison with each other during a contest. This begins with regional as well as provincial decisions and ultimately leads to a federal decision in the German parliament.
The really big learning effect comes from the almost immediate realization that relationships exist, that things are interlinked, and that you cannot steer a complex system using simple linear means.
They are the winners of the Eco-Policy Aid in 2009 and 2010. Fredmund Malik, expert for system theoretical and cybernetic methods in management consulting, invited them to Switzerland. A true professional when it comes to the management of complex systems, he advises companies as well as entire cities, and he sponsors the Eco-Policy Aid.
The Eco-Policy Aid is nothing less than a revolution in education. 2 years ago, 90,000 students took part in Germany. This time, 120,000 participated, and now we have reached almost 200,000. That's a revolution in a completely new way of thinking, and, in the meantime, also the application of these things.
It wouldn't be possible to cope with the challenges of the globalized world without networked thinking, says this management expert. In view of this, the simulation of complex systems, like the game's sensitivity model, is a future-oriented tool.
They provide support wherever things are complex. This means where individual factors are interrelated in a complex and often entwined way. In this respect, we talk about the cybernetics of complex systems. This is the invisible cybernetic functioning of these complex things.
Coached by system experts, the students visiting Malik Management in St. Gallen concern themselves with complex issues from their own environments. It's then no longer a matter of cybernetics land, but rather their future. The subjects are career, choice of career, and career opportunities, and how to influence them.
Our goal was for students to gain initial experience when working systemically. When doing so, they also encountered some aha effects, such as, on the one hand, asking themselves whether the right questions are being posed, and on the other hand, which factors can really be influenced. The first realizations then followed, even though they tended to be contra-intuitive, specifically that the students themselves have only limited possibilities and must therefore put lots of effort in finding out how they can influence their career perspectives.
In some cases, the results are amazing and encourage them to think deeply about the variables. In any event, they provide insight into system relationships. They illustrate, too, how system simulation can be worthwhile, not only in a game, but also in real life.
You have to learn how many things in life influence each other in playing the game. You learn that fact easily without having to face the problems in real life.
I find this very interesting because you can apply it to many situations in life. It was a lot of fun, and I even like to play it in my leisure time. If I understand network thinking really in correlation, it strikes me during my studies at university that the one thing occurs again on the other side. If I perform activity A, not only does B take place, but also C, D and E, and it occurs everywhere again. For me, understanding these interrelationships is a tremendous help.
Munich versus Cologne. The teams trained to face the future's challenges by switching from linear to networked thinking. from the virtual mayor to the actual manager who has a big picture of everything. Scientists promise themselves the magic of functioning from cybernetic tools in the future.
They will be the key tools and key ways of thinking. This is the approach to coping with great complexity and to tackling the greatest challenges of our day.